opportunity to speak on statements on housing, I would have thought it might have changed given the Commission report. And I look at this again as I do all speeches. I listen to them and I read them. And I'm told by the Minister that the housing is working. Housing for all is working, Minister. Now, I can't imagine how a narrative in a speech would continue after you read, or at least the leaked part of the Commission's statement. And so we're told it is working. Well, let me tell you, in Galway City, it is certainly not working. And again, I speak today in the context of the second highest number of people homeless, 13,866, 4,147 are children. That's the second highest, and we're being told that the policy is working. In Galway, there are 288 adults recorded as homeless. And so on. Simon does a regular spot check on what's available. Galway City has nothing available under the HAP scheme. Absolutely nothing, in the discretionary or otherwise. We in our office, as other TDs, are busy putting pressure to get people who are 20 years on a waiting list housed. And they're lucky because they're actually on a housing waiting list. But we've a myriad of schemes introduced by different governments and they don't know where they are. So if you were on a RAS scheme before 2011, you have no longer a right to a social home. You're adequately housed and you go out onto the private market where there are no houses. If you're prior to 11, you are on the list. Post 2011, you're not. HAP, you're not on any list, and then they invented some parallel list. So we have a whole myriad of nonsensical schemes, and I put into that the Help to Buy scheme, and I am at one with Sinn Féin if they're serious about scrapping that scheme, because if our housing policy means that we have to back consultants, and fair play to them for availing of the scheme, but if they have to avail of the Help to Buy scheme to buy a house in Ireland, there's something seriously amiss. And so we have the leaked report from the Commission, and it calls for a radical strategic reset of housing policy, highlights ineffective decision-making and reactive policy-making where risk aversion dominates, calls for an emergency action to address the housing deficit, points out that the pent-up demand outside of population increase, outside of people coming into our country, was never ever factored in. It tells us what's necessary. At the very least, the number of houses that are necessary. It tells us that Ireland has, by comparison with other European partners, one of the highest levels of public expenditure and yet one of the poorest outcome. It calls for, at a basic, a targeted increase in the proportion of social and cost rental housing to 20% of the national stock, and so on. Now, what I want to say about this is we on this side of the House have repeatedly highlighted this to you. I've highlighted it based on my 17 years at local authority level. The housing crisis has been created by policies from various governments that were intent, as Cathal Burry said, Deputy Burry, on making a product of housing, not a basic human right. We stopped building in Galway in 2009 and never built another house till 2020 or 21. And even now, we're not building any affordable houses in Galway City or County. And to add insult to injury, we set up a task force more than 5 years ago. And other than changing the chairperson, who was another former General Secretary of the Housing Department, we have had not one report by way of analysis as to what's happening in Galway City. Just another layer of bureaucracy and continuous expressions of disappointment by the chair that's now gone of the failure of the local authorities to deliver. Do I blame the local authorities? No, I don't. The only thing I blame them for is not being honest with government when we stopped building in 2009. And they should have come back and had the courage to say to the government, this is the making of a housing disaster. We need to build houses. And since then, they've been run down even more. Maybe the minister there can tell us, what are the number of vacancies now in the planning departments? What are the number of vacancies in the housing departments? Because I have a scandalous letter here yesterday from an official in the housing department who cannot give us basic replies as to where someone is on a housing waiting list. Do you know why, minister? They're understaffed, she told me. The person told me, understaffed, and they have more important duties to carry out an assessment, and they can't give us basic answers. I'm over time, Chair. I apologise. Go on, go on.